Hey guys, thanks for waiting. This webinar is going to be how to invest in real estate and how to make passive income starting today. A little bit about me. My name is Paige. I'm a prior Marine currently living on beautiful Hawaii. I graduated college and I tried every wealth building strategy I could find. Pretty quickly, I found myself up to my eyeballs in books, CDs, and debts, and I had absolutely nothing to show for it. While I was in the Marines, I actually met a man who changed my life. He was a little older than I was, a single dad of two girls, 4 and 7, and had just gotten out of the Army, but was fully supporting his family while living in Hawaii just on real estate. After meeting him, I knew very quickly that I needed to learn absolutely everything I could from this man. A little bit of housekeeping stuff. You are all on mute. There's just too many people on the webinar right now. It becomes very distracting. I don't believe in magic bullets. I don't believe in get-rich-quick schemes, so you won't find any of that here. I'm sorry if that's what you're looking for. Now's a good time to leave. This is not a product demo. You're actually going to learn things from this webinar that you can use today. You have to be willing to work. This isn't a get-rich-now scheme. It's a get-rich-forever plan. If you're willing to put in the time, the energy, and the effort, then you will be successful after this webinar. If you're lazy or if you don't want to put in the work, you will not. But if you are a good fit, then this will change the way you look at real estate and just wealth building in general forever. So let's get started. What I'm going to cover today. So right now, this is the quick intros. Next, I'm going to go into a gut check. I'm going to ask you guys some serious questions. I want you to really think about them and how they apply to your actual life. And then I'm going to go over what everyone else is saying and most people don't actually do, and then why they're wrong and what you can do to get financial security for yourself. I'm going to go over the value of having passive income streams in your life. I'll show you my system that you can implement today on your own. I'll show you how to invest in real estate and how that works. I'll show you how to build yourself a portfolio with little to no money, how you can get knowledge you can teach your children to guarantee their financial success. Salim is a close friend of mine. I met him while I was deployed in the Marines, and we were on ship together for 4 months. I gave weekly classes to the Marines and sailors that I was deployed with, and he showed up to one of my classes and then showed up for every single class I gave for the whole rest of my deployment. Sometimes there were twice in the same week. He saw what I was doing and kept asking me questions because he wanted the same results I had. And I actually had to ask him why he came to all the classes, since they're basically the same PowerPoint again and again. And he said it was because he learned something new each and every time. But he says the hardest step was taking the leap of faith and signing up. I put my full confidence in the course and in Paige, and I'm really glad I did. I'm still learning, and I love that I invested money into bettering myself. And that's my buddy Salim. He's still in the Marines right now. Gut check time. I have some serious questions that I want you to ask yourself. Really take the time to think about these. Jim Rohn says that if you don't change yourself dramatically right now, then your next 5 years is going to look just like your last 5 years. And if you don't change yourself, nothing is going to change for you. If you do change yourself, everything is going to change. So my first question is, what is your plan for the next 5 years, and what are you doing right now to get there? What do you have right now to pass on to your kids? What will you leave your kids as a legacy? How are you preparing your kids to be successful financially? A lot of college graduates like me are frustrated because we have like $40,000 to $100,000 in debt and we can't find real jobs. The market's flooded with degrees and not enough jobs for all of us. Are you pushing your kid into the college pipeline hoping they're somehow going to be different than every other kid out there? If you knew how to be financially successful without a degree, would you teach them that, or would you still push them towards college? Imagine if you never had to go to work again. What would you do? What would you do with an extra 20 to 30 free hours every week, or 40 hours, 50 hours? What do you want to be doing with your life that you can't right now because you're stuck underneath a job? The real problem? You aren't getting paid while you sleep. Warren Buffett says, if you don't find a way to make money while you sleep, you'll work until you die. And I don't mean like owning your own job. If you get hired out to fix computers or you own the plumbing company that you work at, that's not really a business. It's only a business if you can completely step out of the company and it still operates, still makes you money without you. When you collect a paycheck while you sleep, that means that even if you lose your job or in an emergency, you still make that money. You'll have a skill that you can teach your children, and you'll have a business and assets that you can pass on to them later. With a proven system, you can learn how to find, fund, and buy your first rental property, how to build a business and protect yourself, your assets, and save you money. learn how you can get started today, and have someone who will walk you through the process to keep you on track. A little bit more about me. I worked just about every part-time job you can think of during and after college, and then I met a man who changed my life with real estate while employed full-time as a Marine. I bought 2 apartment complexes 6 months later, and I brought in about $6,000 a month from that deal alone. And now I own 4 businesses, and as my battalion's finance guy, I taught 342 service members from privates all the way to senior officers on how to make and keep more money. I provided one-on-one business consulting to dozens of people who want to get started but don't know how to begin, and I pretty much became the go-to guy when it came to money or passive income or anything in my unit. Originally, my only goal was to become financially independent, but once other people started seeing me being successful, they wanted to do the same thing for themselves, so they'd ask me to teach their units or come in and talk to their group. They'd pull me aside and ask me for pointers on how to get started or how to make their goals happen, and they'd ask me if they could partner with me on some of my deals and what to do to build businesses for themselves. Every time, I pretty much just echoed what Warren Buffett says and just told him, make money in your sleep. By my last deployment before I got out of the Marine Corps, I had set myself up with real estate and was being paid even while in another country. A common obstacle for people is they say, I can't do real estate because I have other things going on, or I'd constantly have to check in on the property to make sure everything's okay. I was an ocean away from my property, sleeping in a jungle with almost no communications. Like, I had access to my email maybe once a week or so, and it still worked out for me. Also, I'll show you how adding real estate to your hectic life will actually help settle things down for you, because now you're not dependent on your one job. I know, everyone is preaching, take this course and become an investor. I'm gonna be straight up with you. Taking a course is just like getting a degree. You get knowledge, but you don't know how to turn that knowledge into cash. If I got you a textbook on biology, you could read it and still not know how to become a biologist. You need a community of people to partner with, to network with, and learn from. And you need someone who you can ask questions and get recommendations from. Basically a biologist who's gonna teach you how to get paid to be a biologist. So getting started in real estate does not have to be complicated. Building passive income should not be self-taught. I've seen some really bad stuff if you want to get real results. And results are what I deliver, and you'll learn the 3 keys to get these same results today on this webinar. So here are some typical results when you implement what I teach. You'll understand how you can build passive income with real estate. You'll know how to get the money to begin investing. You'll learn how to find and purchase your first deal, and you'll have a proven strategy to get even more properties. I know a lot of you guys are eager to get into the training, so I'm not going to keep babbling on. Let's get started. All right, how to invest in real estate and make passive income today. Training topic number 1, how does real estate work? I really hope that none of you are trying to get rich without doing some math. Please take a moment, pull out a piece of paper and a pen or a pencil and write these down. Number 1, how old are you right now? I'm put my examples, you're going to put yours. 2, how old do you want to be when you retire? I put 60 years old, put whatever is relevant for you. If you want to retire at 30, put 30. 3, how long will you be in retirement? I'm going to die at 100 years old. I'm going to be retired at 60, that's 40 years. So you're going to do the same thing for you. Keep in mind, some people live longer than others, and if your family history says that you're going to live for till you're 150, keep that in mind. Number 4, how much will you need each month to stay retired? So how much are you going to have to spend a month? If you're in a cheap place like Florida or New Mexico, you could probably get away with, you know, around $5,000 a month minimum. But in general, you want around $7,000 to $8,000. And if you're in Hawaii like me or California or New York or somewhere with a high cost of living, or you want to live a luxurious lifestyle, then you're going to want minimum $10,000 a month to be retired. Because that's going to include, you know, your healthcare, any issues you have, travel, your family, your kids, you know, gift giving, just expenses, all of that stuff. All right, this is where the math begins. You're going to take number 4, 10,000, and you're going to multiply it by 12 months, 1 year, and number 3, which is how long you're going to be in retirement, so 40. That is going to be your total savings. How much you need per month times 12 months times how many years you're going to be retired is how much you're going to need saved up in order to be retired and you know, live off of that retirement savings alone. For me to have $10,000 a month for 40 years, I need just under $5 million. You're going to take answer number two, so 60 years old, minus number 1, which is 30 years old, my age now, and that's going to be how long I have to make that money to number 5. So I have 30 years to make $5 million. You should be able to see that you have your amount of time to make your amount of money. Oh, and that does not factor inflation. So this is going to be how much you're going to need per month. So this is a little bit more accurate representation of how much you're going to need depending on how long you want to stay in retirement. The red column on the left, you're going to look at how long you're going to be retired. And the blue row across the top is going to be how much you need per month. You're going to match those up. And I put a little blue box around mine. So instead of 5 million, I actually need almost 6.5 million in my savings in order to retire off $10,000 a month. So you find your number, and I would write that down as well on your same sheet. If I told you to get one dozen eggs, what would you do? You'd go to the store, you know, grocery store, and you'd go buy eggs and say, ta-da. But what if I told you to get 10 dozen eggs? Would that change anything? You might go to the store still, but if you're smart, you're going to go somewhere where you can get it wholesale. You're going to go to BJ's or Costco or, you know, somewhere where you can get more eggs for less price. What if I told you to get 100 dozen eggs? Again, you might go to the store, but you're going to spend a lot more. You might go to wholesaler, but still going to be expensive. So you'd go straight to the farmer and say, hey, let me get 100 dozen eggs. But if I told you to get 1 million eggs, how would you do that? Like, would that change anything? Yeah, you're going to go to the source. You're going to get chickens. Why? Because chickens make eggs. More chickens equals more eggs. So for this example, investment properties are the chickens, and passive income is the eggs. Investment properties make passive income. More investment properties means more passive income. Now in school, we're taught the bucket philosophy. What that basically is that they teach you to work really hard, and every time you get a paycheck, take a little bit of your money and put it into your bucket for retirement. So you're adding to the bucket little bits over time, over time, over time. You keep adding more and more and more. And then once you finally fill up the bucket enough that you're happy and you think you can live off of it the rest of your life, you stop adding to the bucket and you start drinking out of the bucket. And then you drink out of the bucket your entire retirement. And then when you die, you give whatever's left in your bucket to your family. That's the overall premise. Now, the problem with this philosophy is what happens if life kicks over your bucket? Like, what happens if you have a medical issue or an emergency or something comes up that you have to tap into your retirement or you lose your job? You know, something that changes. Your bucket gets kicked over. Well, now you're screwed because you have to start over. Or what happens if you're living and you saved up all your money, you got the right amount, you retired when you planned, you're living through retirement, and then you outlive your plan? So instead of dying at 80, you die at 120. Well, now for those last few years, you now have to go get a job because you're out of money. Make sure you're taking the time to plan accordingly. I'm going to show you guys a better philosophy. I call it the faucet philosophy. The faucet philosophy is instead of contributing little bits of money every single paycheck into your bucket, you take that money and use it to buy faucets. These faucets are going to be assets, anything that makes you money, like your rental income. So you take that money and you buy, we'll say, an investment property. Then, as that investment property collects money from rent every single month, it's dripping into your bucket for you. Plink, plink, plink. It's not fast, but it's steady and it's over time and it's automatic. So then, as you accumulate more and more money, you then take that money and you buy a second faucet. Plunk, 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 plunk. Plunk, plunk, and you can see how this is going to start compounding. Then you take that money and you buy another faucet, you buy another faucet, you keep doing that. Over time, you start to pay off those faucets, those assets. So you pay off your mortgages on rental property. And now you're getting more money per property because you don't have to pay for the mortgage. So instead of just being a drip, you actually get a steady stream of income, if you will, a steady stream of water into your bucket. So now when you retire, you're drinking out of your bucket and it's refilling itself. And oftentimes it's refilling itself faster than you can drink it. And that's true retirement. That's true financial stability. That's our goal. Now, the beauty of this is if life comes along and kicks over your bucket, you know, you have an emergency or you lose your job or, you know, you have medical issues that happen and life kicks over your bucket, you just stand it back up and it'll refill itself. So now you're not as desperate to go find work when you're, you know, 95 years old and in a wheelchair. This is a much better philosophy. That's the one I teach all of my Marines and sailors and all of my clients, the faucet philosophy. I'm gonna show you guys how to do this. Imagine I gave you $1 million. I have no idea how much this is. That looks like a lot more than $1 million. But imagine I give you $1 million and we're gonna assume that you're actually smart with this money and you're gonna buy one house. So you buy $1 million house and you rent it out because you want an investment property. The agreement, the terms, are you have to pay me back $5,000 every single month. You owe me $5,000 a month and you own a $1 million rental property. I'm going to keep the numbers really, really easy for you. There's a lot of factors that come into play for how much rent is and depending on location and house and all of that. But in general, you can rent a $1 million house for more or less than this. But for this example, we're going to say you collect $5,000 a month off your $1 million house. If you're collecting $5,000 a month and you're paying me $5,000 a month, how much are you making? Zero. But what do you have? You have a $1 million house that's paying itself off. Over the next 20, 30 years as it pays itself off, guess what? You're now a millionaire because it's paid off. You can sell that house for $1 million whenever you want. On top of that, you're still making $5,000 a month. Even when it's fully paid off, you're still getting that income. So you can see how you can create passive income. It's going to take time. It's not a get-rich-quick scheme. But over time, you now have this asset that's going to build you up. And, you know, you might be at your retirement right now. $5,000 a month in 20 years, that could be exactly where you wanted to be or halfway there. Let's say same scenario. I give you your $1 million and you go out and buy two $500,000 houses instead of the one. $500,000 house is going to rent for around $3,000 a month. So now you have two $500,000 houses, same $1 million loan. And so you collect $6,000 a month. Now the beauty of this is you still pay me $5,000 a month. So what that means is you collect six, you pay me five, and you keep one. Now there are a lot of other expenses that go into houses and taxes and stuff like that, but we're gonna omit those just for this example for simplification purposes. So if you're paying me $5,000 and you're bringing in $6,000, you make a $1,000 profit. That is called cash flow. So whenever you pay for all of your expenses and you still make money, that's cash flow, and you now have a business. We like cash flow. That's pretty much our goal here. So you'll have two houses, $500,000 each, and each one is bringing in an extra cash flow every single month. We're going to keep playing with this example. Instead of two $500,000 houses, you buy five $200,000 houses. Each one rents for about $1,800. You're now looking at $9,000 a month. So now you're getting $4,000 cash flow on top of having five houses on that same $1 million investment. Let's keep playing. On $100,000 houses, you would get 10 of them, and that would be around $10,000 a month. So $50,000 houses rent for $700 a month about. So you're looking at $14,000. If you're paying me $5,000 a month, that means you're keeping $9,000 a month. So that means you have 20 houses, you're keeping $9,000 a month, and you're paying me off. And now you have your cash flow. You could retire right now. Remember you said, you know, around $10,000 was your retirement. So if you're making $9,000 right now, you could retire today off that $1 million loan. Now that's impractical. No one's going to give you a $1 million loan, but could you get a $50,000 loan today? Yeah, probably. Almost anyone could get a $50,000 loan, especially because it's backed by real estate. It's secured. So you'll get a mortgage on a $50,000 loan. You put some money down and you buy your first house. And then a year from now, you get another down payment together and you buy another $50,000 house. A year from then, you do it again. The next year, you do it again. Over 20 years, you have 20 houses if you do it at one house a year. Those are those 20 houses right here that I was telling you about. You have 20 $50,000 houses. That's $1 million in assets. That's $14,000 a month. That's exactly what I said over the 20 years. So bam, not get rich quick, get rich for sure. That said, pro tip, I never spend $50,000 on a $50,000 house. I will pay generally around $40,000 for a $50,000 house so that I know I profit from the very first day. And that will include all the repairs, the acquisition fees, everything else to make sure that I make money from day one. And those are types of strategies I'll teach you a little bit later. Training topic number two. So where do you find these kinds of deals? Now, your first deal, full disclosure, is going to be messy, especially if you do it alone. So you're going to make mistakes, you're going to miss steps, you're going to, you know, just things happen. Make them as small and affordable as possible, so start very, very small. So here's some tips for your first deal. Mistakes cost more the bigger the deal. So small acquisitions, small repairs, small issues. Keep everything small. Local is a lot easier to manage because you have experience. You know the area, you know the value, you know issues that are common in your area, and you have a network that can help you around the area. So local is a lot easier if you can. Some areas are very expensive and you just can't do local. Find experts, plumbers, contractors. As a pro tip, don't pay them until they're done the work. Get reputable people who are experts and know what they're doing to take care of you and do the work. Don't half-ass it or cut corners. Partner to divide the load, especially get an experienced partner, you know, someone who knows what they're doing. Say, hey, I'll partner with you. I'll do this, you do that, and show me how it's done. And that way you get, you know, comfortable. You're going to miss things. Things are going to happen. So plan for those ahead of time. Keep a lot of extra cash on hand. You know, keep a buffer and you should be good. Location, location, location. I'm sure you've heard this. Location is everything. You want a bad house in a nice neighborhood, not the nicest neighbor or the nicest house in a bad neighborhood. Because you can fix a bad house in a nice neighborhood, and now, you know, you get your returns back, you can rent it out easily, and everything's happy hunky-dory. But if you take a nice house in a crap neighborhood, you can't fix the whole neighborhood, and you're already like at the cap of how much money and how much return you're gonna make on that. You don't want to be the nicest house in the neighborhood. You want to buy a crap house that's in a nice neighborhood and then fix it up so that it's on par with the rest of the houses. Plus, everyone else will be happy because now the property values will go up. Next, make sure that, you know, use Zillow or a local agent for your first property. Use properties that are listed on the market. It's safer, you know, they're already on the market, they're already vetted, they're taken care of, you know, and some areas are better than others. You know, talk to your local real estate agent. Do not start deal two until deal one is completely done. Finish what you start, and you don't want to bite off more than you can chew. I know many, many, many people that get very excited about this and they just jump in and they think it's good, and then they jump into their next one and they realize, oh crap, I wasn't quite done with deal number one. So, you know, take your time. This is your time to practice. And in short, you're going to make mistakes. Things are going to happen. Just make them small and as affordable as possible. And your best first deal is on the market. Do it right the first time. So here is your easy first deal play-by-play. One, go on Zillow and look at your preferred area. What this is for is familiarization. You're gonna look at Craigslist, you know, how much are things renting for, you know, what are the house values, what's for sale. This is familiarization. Do not take it all at face value, and do not take this as the actual value or price or anything like that. Everything is in flux, but this is a good place to start. Then contact a few real estate agents. Tell them you're looking for a long-term rental property. What this is gonna do is, one, you're gonna start building your network. Two, you're gonna see that some are way better than others. And three, you're gonna start finding deals and, you know, seeing what you can and can't afford and what'll work in your area. Collect listings, get organized. Put them all in a binder or folder or online, it doesn't matter. You're gonna ask what repairs, why are they selling, you know, prices, areas, rents, etc. You know, ask a lot of questions. Ask your agents, ask the seller, you know, ask the contractors. Make sure you get all the information you can. I cannot emphasize, organization is everything. So write everything down listing by list. Keep everything together. This house at this address, here's pictures, this contractor went through, it needs these repairs, I'm working with this agent, so on and so forth. Keep organized, you know, folders and folders or files and files, however you want to do it. You want a fixer-upper in a good neighborhood for the best value. Now you're gonna have to have the cash on hand or the loan or the money for the repairs, but and it's gonna be more work, but you're gonna get more value. If you don't have the money for repairs, then you want one that's a light cosmetic rehab. And all that means is they need paint or change carpet, you know, things that are pretty superficial and cheap. Still in a good neighborhood, and that's gonna be the least work, but still with fixer-upper. If you find a property that's already completely ready to go, new carpet, new paint, you know, all of that, then now you're gonna end up overpaying because you still have to pay for acquisition fees and inspections and everything else. Keep that in mind, that you wanna put some work into it to not have to overpay. And lastly, just narrow down your options, run your numbers, make an offer, and close. You have to actually do it. That's overall the process. This is a very, very simple how-to for a simple deal if you want to get started like right now. The biggest problem with this is that you're not going to get any profit up front. You're pretty much competing with everyone else on the market because these properties are listed, and you're going to have to pay your agent, the seller's agent. You're pretty much going to start out upside down on the mortgage, and all that means is that, you know, the house is worth $50,000 and you had to pay $60,000 or $65,000 in order to buy it with all the inspections and closing fees and stuff. You're going to owe slightly more money than the value of the house. So keep that in mind, that, you know, if you're trying to pay this off over time and it's a buy and hold, is that still going to work for you? And, you know, do your homework ahead of time. Plus, you can't really be creative when you buy a house that's on the market. I've got a bunch of cool creative strategies that I use to get houses cheap or easier. And you can't really do that if it's on the market because you can't work with them as well. They're not as flexible. How to run numbers on a purchase. First, how much is it worth 100% ready? So if it needs repairs, after the repairs. If it's already repaired, how much is it worth right now? How much are you buying it for? What is your purchase price? How much is it going to cost to appraise and inspect? How much will it cost for you to repair? Now, your repairs plus your purchase should be less than the value. That's how you make a profit. Otherwise, you're going to be upside down, like I was saying. What loans can you get approved for? Have you already talked to your bank? You know, do you know what your value you can buy? How big of a house you can afford right now? And how long are those repairs going to take? The longer the repairs take, the more expensive it becomes, because in addition to paying for the repairs, you're still paying for taxes and everything else every month that may or may not add up. Well, it will add up. There are more advanced strategies for how to do this consistently and ensure that you always come out on top, including where to look or what to look for, questions to ask, but I'm going to save those for later. This is the absolute bare bones. You want to get started today, I'm going to give you that information. Write those down. That is how to run numbers on a purchase. Running numbers on a rental is a little bit different because you're looking at each month. How much is your mortgage? How much do you have to pay the bank every single month? How much is your insurance? So this is per year, but you want to divide it by month so that you know how much it's going to be and start adding up and prepare for that. How much is your taxes? Same thing for every single month. How much will your repairs cost each month, and how much will the holding be each month? What is the vacancy? So how often do people move in and move out? You know, how long does it generally linger? That's going to be around 8 to 10% usually. And how much is typical rent per month in that area? And keep in mind, street by street can vary slightly. So, you know, talk to experts, really understand what is the rent, what can you expect? There are other numbers that you want to factor depending on your location and situation, like homeowner association fees. These are just the starter numbers to get on track for beginners. At the end of the webinar, I'll show you my spreadsheet for how do I assess deals and decide if they're good or bad. So be sure to stick around and grab that after this webinar, and you can use that as well. Ask questions. Ask more questions. Ask your agent, ask your contractor, ask your plumber. Ask everyone everything you can to learn and take notes and, you know, stay organized and you'll be all right. More pro tips. Appraise every single property before you buy it. Inspect every single property professionally before you buy it. So have a contractor, have a plumber, have an electrician, have these people walk through. Even if it costs you a couple $100s, it's better than the thousands and thousands that you didn't know after you bought it. Have multiple contractors bid on the rehabs and compete with each other. Write absolute everything down. Save every single receipt, stay as organized as possible from the get-go, and you'll go far. Talk to real estate agents for estimated value and how easy or hard it is to rent. You know, talk to people that know the area well and know the market and figure out, you know, those information that you don't know. Different areas are better for different strategies. Some are good for buying it, repairing it, and selling it. That's called flipping. Others are good for buying it, repairing it, and renting it out and keeping it long term. That's called holding. Training topic number three. Where do you get the money? This is the number one biggest question that I get from absolutely everyone, especially while I was enlisted in the Marine Corps. Where do you get the money to get started in real estate? Really briefly, I'm going to go over a bunch of options. There are a lot more than this, and there's a lot cooler strategies than these, but these are some of the options available to you right now for real estate. So you have mortgages, personal loans, personal lines of credit, home equity lines of credit, seed capital, hard money lenders, private lenders, and many, many more. Real quick, mortgages are a loan on a house. So the bank says, hey, you want to buy this house? Cool, you give us 10 to 20% down. We will provide the rest. You're going to pay us every single month until it's paid off plus interest. It's secured by real estate. So if you stop paying, they take away your house. This is the bread and butter of the real estate industry. And you're looking at generally, if you want a $100,000 loan, then you have to pay around $10,000 to $30,000 down, which means the bank is going to provide 70 to 90% LTV or loan to value. They're going to provide 70%, you're going to provide 30, or they're going to provide 90, you're going to provide 10. So keep that in mind. These are pretty straightforward. Talk to your bank. They'll work with you. They're relatively low costs and low rates, especially if you have a good credit score. These are the bread and butter. These are where to start. Personal loans. These are very common. This is an unsecured. It doesn't have anything backing it up. So generally, your limits are going to be a lot lower. Banks will give you, you know, a $10,000 personal loan or a $5,000 personal loan or something like that. The interest rates are going to be higher. It's one-time use. So they say, hey, here's a bunch of cash. And now you have to pay them back. And once it's paid back, done. That's it. Because it's not secured, it's going to be moderate rates, but it's pretty straightforward. Every time you want one of these, you have to reapply. They may or may not approve you for all of them. So be careful. personal lines of credit. So the way this works is think of it like a credit card, or it's a bank account filled with money. As long as the bank account's filled with money, then you don't pay anything. Then every time you take that money out, you withdraw it just like cash because it's a bank account. So when you take that money out, you now have to pay interest on what's missing for as long as it's missing. Then you pay it back and you no longer have to pay interest anymore. Just like a credit card having a balance or not having a balance, it's just inverted. So you buy a house, you get your mortgage, you know, you put your money down, and then you use your PLOC, your personal line of credit, for the repairs. So you do all the repairs, and then you sell the house for a flip, you get that money back, you pay off your PLOC, and now you can use it on the next deal. You don't have to apply for a whole another personal loan. It just stays with you. And that's what the beauty of this one. You know, you can use this for, you know, years and years and years and multiple deals and all of that. So PLOCs are great. Similarly, the HELOC, the home equity line of credit, is just like the PLOC, except this one they use your home equity as the collateral. So this is considered secured by your house, just like a mortgage. Now, the home equity line of credit is limited by whatever your home equity is. If you paid off your entire house and now you want to start using that as collateral for future deals, you can absolutely do that. Just talk to a bank and they're generally pretty good about working with you. Because it's secured, it's going to be lower interest rates than the PLOC, and again, it's a revolving credit and lifetime access type of thing. So these are really, really handy. Seed capital. So this is less common, but you're going to see ads for it, especially as you start getting started in real estate, and I want you to understand what it is. So all they do is they give you a whole bunch of credit cards, they withdraw a whole bunch of cash off the credit cards, and then you use that cash to fund your deal or your business or your repairs or whatever. For the first 6 months to a year, it's at 0% APR, so no interest. Pay no interest for the first 6 months, it's that kind of thing. Then after that 6 months or 1 year expires, they amp up the APR, the interest rate, to, you know, 20-25%. So for the first 6 months you pay zero, the second 6 months now you pay 25%. And so these are considered very, very risky one-time use. And they're risky because if you buy a house and you're going to repair it and sell it, and so you use this and then you fix it all up and everything's good to go and you put it on the market and it just sits there and nobody buys your house, then now your interest rate skyrockets and you're still sitting on the house and now you're paying these really high interest rates, and that's going to eat away at your profit margin, and then eventually you're going to start losing money. You want to be very, very careful with seed capital. I just want you to understand what it is. So they'll say low rates now, super high rates later. And because it's a bunch of credit cards, it's also going to really affect your credit score. Hard money lenders. So these are very, very common. All this is companies that will lend you money at higher interest rates and higher points for businesses and real estate. Instead of giving you up to 90% of the value of the house, they'll only give you generally around 70, but it's still secured by the house, and these are pretty straightforward as well. They want high credit scores, but they're generally more flexible than a bank. That's why you would use them instead of a bank. And they charge points and rates. Rates is the APR, the normal interest rate. They also charge points, which is if you get a $100,000 loan and they charge 3 points, then that's going to be 3% of the loan, so $3,000, is added on to the loan. So you get $100,000, but you have to pay them $103,000 plus interest on the $103,000. So they get the extra $3,000 plus some extra interest off of that. And that can add up too. If you have to do this broker's points and this broker's points plus this loan's points, 3 points plus 3 points plus 3 points, you're now looking at 9 points. So 9% on top of your loan. Just be cognizant of that. Private lenders, so this is family and friends in your own network. These are under your terms. It's whatever you guys agree to. If you want to give them, you know, 8% or 10% or whatever, then that's up to you guys, and it's how you guys want to contract it. But they lend you money, and you use it to buy real estate, and you pay them back as if they were the bank. So they're the mortgage. And they can use retirement accounts. You can use your retirement account or their retirement account, and they give it to you. You invest it. You pay them back as agreed, and that money goes back into their retirement account with the same tax deductions and all that. So if that's something you're interested in, there are professionals that will help you with that. You just need to start connecting with people and building your network. Pro tip, avoiding scammers. If a lender offers you super low APR, super high loan amounts, Gmail email addresses, can give you a loan in less than 30 days, wants money up front, they usually call this a filing fee or application fee, or sounds too good to be true, don't do it. So if they offer an APR anywhere below like 6%, I'm already sketched out. If they offer a really high loan amount where they're like, we'll give you $2 million or $4 million or even, you know, $500,000, we won't do a credit check, you know, all these other things, those should be red flags for you. If they have a Gmail email address, you know, I'm not going to get into all of these, but basically if they want your money up front for any reason, then they're going to say, yeah, give us this money, and then they'll either reject you or just disappear. And now they just made money off of you, and you get scammed. And generally, people get scammed multiple times before they learn. So please avoid scammers. Use private money in your own network. All right, so my dream is to transform the way that you think about money. Passive income doesn't have to be hard, and you can get started in real estate without going crazy. Financial freedom is not a wild goose chase, and I've led hundreds of people just like you through their first real estate deal and into passive income with little to no money out of their pockets. Now, I want to help you. I want you to free yourself from financial stress and spend more time with your friends and family. I'll walk you through how you can make a profit on the first day you buy a property and secure yourself for the rest of your life in any market condition. Let me tell you a little bit more about myself. So I graduated high school with almost all A's and played on varsity sports. I pretty much did everything I was supposed to do. I knew that I was going to pay for my own tuition, so I went to a little school in Florida and I got a job as a cook as soon as I started. I ended up being an event manager, a personal assistant, and I got a job waiting tables just to keep up with my tuition and everything. With all the part-time jobs, I was probably working around 60 to 70 hours every week while going to school full-time, and I had to save up every dollar I made to pay cash for the following semester. And I rode a bicycle from work to class to work to save money and time. I was biking over 12 miles a day and became well known as the guy who wore different uniforms to every single class and didn't go to any parties. I squeezed in my homework while I was on shift. I did try multi-level marketing. I found it on Craigslist and they were advertising $15 just for a 1 hour appointment. So I biked over to the meeting, you know, I get there and they never told me that I'd have to pay $300 just to participate. I did give it a shot. I paid my $300. I met with a handful of people. I memorized their speeches, and actually I almost had a few sales. One time they were sitting with this lady, I would have closed the sale, but I actually backed down. The set of knives wasn't going to turn her into Martha Stewart or get her to cook more often for her family. I just couldn't cheat anyone or lie to make a sale. She actually thanked me and still made a purchase. I sold one ice cream scoop. I made $3. So yeah, I threw in the towel on MLM that day. And I definitely couldn't sell anything that I just didn't believe in, or I didn't believe it would help people. I decided I was going to go and work for myself. I worked tuning and fixing bikes, cleaning and repairing and modifying computers for people on campus. I basically just made money here and there wherever I could, but I was still working like 60 to 70 hours every week just to pay for tuition. I graduated, and after, didn't get any easier. I had two bachelor's degrees. I thought I did everything the right way. I mean, I had good grades. I had a whole bunch of work experience, but it wasn't the right experience when I went on interviews. I ended up working after college as a security guard, a waiter, a bartender, construction worker, security guard, just, you know, any jobs I could find. And I ended up enlisting in the Marine Corps so that it gave me a chance to really just settle down and plan my future. During that time, I bought every book and course that I could possibly find on money and business. I spent just about every spare penny I had on educating myself, and I tried everything short of selling my kidneys, and that's only really because the Marine Corps frowns upon black market sale of organs. Eventually, I got tired. I gave up. I had to go talk to the Navy chaplain because I was so pissed off all the time at, you know, everyone. I just felt like I had put in so many countless hours reading and learning, and I stuffed my brain with everything I could possibly find, but I just had nothing to show for it. I had high balanced credit cards, stupid amounts of spam emails, and overflowing boxes and boxes of books and CDs and stuff. And I just got burnt out. So I went to the chaplain to talk to him about my issues. I'm pretty sure he saw how frustrated I was because he told his assistant to move his meeting and just hold all calls for the afternoon. After an hour of just venting, we were sitting down in his office, and I really don't know what I expected. I mean, I knew he couldn't really do anything, you know, but he actually smiled. He said, go find a hobby that has nothing to do with the Marines or work or just anything. Just get off base. So naturally, I went back to Craigslist. There was an ad for a group that meets for a coffee shop and plays board games every single week. And I was like, yeah, sure, I'll check it out. And I got there and I discovered they were paying cash flow, which is the board game that's in Rich Dad, Poor Dad. And they were just teaching people the basics of money. I had heard of the concepts before, but it was the first time I learned really about real estate and passive income. And I met with the group twice a week, every week for over a year. They were a tight-knit group of investors. They had built themselves up, a bunch of real estate, commercial, residential, all of that. They branched into some businesses. They had some restaurants. Like they were doing really well. And so I was like, I'm going to stick around these guys forever. And I just asked thousands and thousands of questions, you know, like, where did you guys learn how to do all of this? The first thing that they taught me was the word kina ole. So kina ole is their value system in Hawaiian. And what it means is doing the right thing in the right way, at the right time, in the right place, to the right person, for the right reason, with the right feeling, the first time. It really resonated with me. And they taught me to live with appreciation instead of expectation. When they worked on deals together, they never asked, like, what's in it for me? It was all for the group. They were all part of one family, an ohana. It made the group stronger, and because of that, it really made them more successful, just because they weren't going at it alone. They taught me how to find properties, tax incentives, how to protect myself. After 6 years of grinding day in and day out, and 6 years of working 60 to 70 hour weeks or never getting ahead, I finally felt like I was gonna make it. They helped me with my first deals. They walked me through and partnered with me. And I did everything that they taught me. I found deals, I ran numbers, I made offers, I closed the deals, and I made money. And I lived kina ole. The system just, it worked. In the first 6 months, I bought apartment complexes, bringing in $6,000 a month. I bought vending machines that brought in $5,000 a month. I was so excited that I shared my results with the Marines around me. And my teammate, he invested. He was making money within 30 days. Another Marine I met on deployment, he jumped in on vending machines and he made $5,000 a month. Basically, the more I taught people about passive income, the more people asked me how to do it for themselves. So there were no more 60-hour work weeks, no more multi-level marketing meetings, or no more appointments, no more get-rich-quick schemes, no more cold calling. I learned genuine skills that I could use to start a business, to obtain assets, and just to build long-term recession-proof, you know, financial security. I applied that knowledge to residential and commercial properties, businesses, vending machines. By learning the basics for starting a business, I applied that process to build more and more streams of passive income. The gurus and get-rich-quick schemes I paid thousands of dollars for never even paid for themselves. Multi-level marketing, sales jobs, they never really got me any kind of stability. Even earning magna cum laude with 2 degrees from a state university didn't cover what I paid to go there. Skip everything I went through. Just skip the thousands of dollars I spent, the obstacles I overcame to learn what I know now, that those things just don't work. After 6 years of painstaking research and trial and error, after tens of thousands of dollars wasted, I finally discovered the secret of passive income. And there's really just 3 key factors for success that gurus and get-rich-quick schemes just don't tell you. 1, you don't need to know everything. I read everything, I listened to everything. You only need to know the right things. Understanding how to start a business applies to e-commerce, real estate, vending machines, you know, anything. 2, you can't achieve financial freedom trading your time for money. You need multiple sources of passive income that are going to fill your bank account every single month. And 3, you need a team. You can't do this alone. And I don't mean an upline or a downline either. You need people who genuinely care about your success and want to work with you. But that's really it. No matter what the gurus say, or no matter what your friends or family promise you about joining their MLM, if you really want to be financially free long term, you need to create a business that's going to provide that income for you. It's with these 3 pieces of truth that I actually built my businesses while working full time as a Marine over the last 3 years. Finally, after 6 years of searching, I found stability. By focusing on passive income instead of sales, consulting, e-commerce, or MLM, I make money while I sleep. Like, if I get hit by a car or I'm in a coma, I still get paid. If I travel the world or disconnect from the internet, the money still gets deposited into my bank account. It's not a get-rich-quick scheme. It's not an instant business. It's not a sales job. There is no selling to family and friends, no mandatory meetings every week, no cold calling, it's just knowledge. I'll show you how to build a business for yourself that will take care of you for the rest of your life.
You can learn for yourself risk-free, and you can join my team risk-free.
The knowledge has transformed thousands of people just like you into business owners and real estate investors. There's an easy-to-follow video course. It's going to provide you step-by-step instructions for building a full business model from nothing, and you can watch it again and again forever. What makes working with me, unlike other real estate courses, is really just my purpose. I want you to succeed. I want to show you how to use real estate to make passive income for yourself. I'll show you what to do, and I'll include why you're doing what you're doing. You'll understand the difference between an S-corp, an LLC, a C-corp, a joint ventureship, a sole proprietorship, and then you'll understand why you'll want one over another depending on your business. That way you can apply that knowledge to other business ventures as well. After this course, you'll have business skills that can be translated from real estate into any business venture you get involved in. Imagine no more meetings, no rushing to get dinner on the table before a second, third, or fourth job. Imagine not having to balance your work time with your family time. Imagine taking your family on a vacation as a business trip. Through passive income, you don't have to worry about if you lose your job or if you have health concerns or if your retirement savings aren't quite enough. You'll still make money. I'm sure you can see how life-changing it'll be when you go from working 70 hours a week stressing about money, finally reaching long-term financial security. You'll understand how to start and run a business, how to obtain passive income. You can repeat this process as many times as you'd like and obtain more and more cash flow every month. Picture a stool with only three legs. If you lose a leg, the stool collapses. How many legs does your stool have right now? Do you only have one income, one leg? Many of your friends who've watched you struggle through gurus and get-rich-quick schemes, multi-level marketing, will want to know how you finally reached stability. They'll beg to know how they can get security in their lives as well. This unique course is taught by top experts in each of their respective fields. Like the instructor who teaches the tax and legal classes is a CPA, he's a tax attorney, a real estate attorney, and owns a legal firm that supports small businesses. He nets over $1 million per year from his law firm alone. The guy who teaches how to acquire properties with little to no money out of his pocket has made thousands of similar purchases. The man who teaches about commercial property brings in millions of dollars of passive income just from renting out malls, business spaces, and other commercial properties. You'll learn it all from masters and be set up for success from the beginning. Here's just a small fraction of what you'll learn from this course. You'll learn skills to build a business from scratch that can be applied to any business, including real estate, so you can start a business in any industry using this information. You'll learn how to buy real estate with little to no money out of your pocket, so you can get started immediately. You'll learn how to protect yourself and your business and your legal responsibilities, so you can safely build a long-lasting passive income for yourself and your family. You'll learn a strategy for building a portfolio over time to ensure you retire in comfort and not worry about, you know, running out of savings or emergencies. You'll build a legacy you can share with your family and pass on to your kids, and you'll be able to teach your kids a skill that's a surefire way to financial freedom. I'm sure you can see exactly how powerful this education will be for you, and how you can finally reach the financial security and stability you've been looking for. This education is the blueprint I used to transform from 60-hour work weeks and struggling to get by into having passive income deposited into my bank account each month. I want to make this decision a no-brainer for you, so in addition to the classes, you'll also have direct contact with me, so we can discuss your education, your deals, find you partners. You can partner with me, and we could work step-by-step on your first deals to make sure you're comfortable with the process, so you can repeat it again and again. I'll also include my ebook on money skills that should be taught in our schools but aren't. I've given this course to over 300 Marines and sailors while deployed, and after my unit commander watched the class, I was assigned the job as battalion financial advisor. Usually I sell this book, but with your education purchase, I'll include my Money 101 ebook for no additional cost. Plus, I'll give you access into my private forum where you and others like you can ask me questions, or work together on any business venture, real estate deal, or you can post questions for me to answer publicly to help everyone learn together. You'll surround yourself with other driven people who want to build long-term profitable businesses for themselves. You can post experiences, challenges, questions, advice. The forum is free of spammers and freeloaders. It's exclusively other passionate people who are fed up with get-rich-quick schemes and are ready to build something permanent for themselves, and who believe in Kina Ole. So, what does this course cost? If all this system did for you was double your free time, double your time with your family, and give you financial security for the rest of your life, would you pay $10,000 for that? Imagine spending more time with your family and not looking at your bank statement every month. How much would you pay for that? How much would you pay to not have to worry about an emergency expense coming up? What would it be worth having something that you could teach your kids so they were set for the rest of their lives? Tell me, what is your vision, your mission, your dream? Think about your dream right now. What if you never had to worry about money coming in again? How would you feel? How would that affect your life? After what I just showed you, could you see how this education, a proven system, could support your vision? See that you could get passive income for yourself? If so, my goal today is not to sell you on the training tool concept. It works, plain and simple.
And I'd bet that if you let me train you, it could change your life overnight, like it did for mine and many clients.
So I have one question for you. Do you want me to walk you through your first deal, answer your questions, and help you get passive income? I know that once my system is fully implemented into your life, you'll have real estate bringing you passive income, you'll have a secure and protected business, and you'll have knowledge that you can pass on to your kids to ensure their financial success. These results are not being pulled out of thin air. I'm basing this on my personal experience, my clients' experiences, and the fact that since 2009, I've been training people just like you how to get crazy results in their lives. The best way to see if my program is a perfect fit for you is to roll up your sleeves, get on the phone, and I'll walk you through it to see how it would work for you. There are a few conditions that you need to be aware of. First, there's only one of me, so over the next 30 days, I can only work with a handful of clients. Secondly, I only work with people who I think will see results. You must have what it takes, so there's a simple application process to find out if you're the right person for my training. You need to be teachable, have what it takes to be successful, and actually execute to get real results. Remember, I want you to be wildly successful, and if I don't think you're going to make it there, then I don't want to waste yours or my time. So here's the deal. First, under this presentation, you need to scroll down and click on the Book a Session with Paige button below. When you click on that, it will open a simple calendar that will allow you to grab a time on my personal calendar. There will also be a few questions to answer about your business so I can get a good feel before we hop on our free call together. When we do that, one of two things will happen. Number one, most likely, you'll say, "Wow, this is amazing. I want to take it to the next level." And then we talk about what to do next.
Scenario number two, unlikely, is you'll say, "You know what? This isn't what I thought it was going to be, and I was hoping for something else."
In the unlikely event that number two happens, I'll send you a free gift that I currently sell for $297. I'm not going to tell you what the training product is right now because I wouldn't want anyone to feel weird about me just giving it away, but you'll get it for free. No strings attached. It's just a way of saying thanks for reaching out to me and taking your time to talk with me. That's how confident I am about what I have to teach and show you in our call. You're either going to be totally amazed, get the step-by-step online course for life, a copy of my Money 101 ebook, and access to my private forum, or you get this $297 gift in exchange for your time. No matter what, you win. So here's what you're going to do next. Press the button below this presentation, grab a time on my calendar. Once we receive your info, I'll give you a quick email reminder of the time you booked for our call, and I'll call you on that day and time. Notice number one, when I run out of time, I can't add more. Number two, you need to be available for your strategy session when you request it. If you're not, then you'll forfeit your spot to work with me, which also means pushing your success back that much longer. And number three, this webinar training is being viewed by hundreds of people over the next few days, and the strategy sessions are only on a first-come, first-served basis. With that said, you and I both know my available time slots will be reserved fast, so you need to grab a time with me right now. Thanks a lot for listening and booking a time with my calendar. I know you're going to love this, and I look forward to talking with you soon, so go ahead and push that button now.